Hello everyone, welcome to another module in this online course, Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. And we have now looked at several examples of mixed strategy Nash equilibria. Let us continue this and let us look at a couple of other games with mixed strategy Nash equilibria. In particular, let us now look at an interesting game of paying taxes, which is applicable in real life scenarios where individuals are paying taxes. And this is a game between the taxpayers, the individuals, and the auditors or the people, the tax officials who are trying to audit this. So, this is a game between taxpayers and the auditors. So, this is a game between the taxpayers and auditors. Let us denote the taxpayers by T, let us denote the auditors by A. And they have the taxpayers, and both of them have different actions. The taxpayers can either be honest in reporting their taxes H, or they can cheat, that is, they can cheat on their taxes to try to save on tax money, right. So, the taxpayers can either be honest or cheat. And the auditors, of course, they cannot audit every tax form or every tax return that has been submitted. So, they have an option to randomly either audit, that is A, or not audit, that is N. So, we are looking at a game in which both these players, there is an asymmetry, that is, the actions of both the players are different. That is, the taxpayers can either pay the taxes, that is, be honest or cheat, and the auditors can either audit or not audit. And let us now draw the game table for this game, and again we can draw the game table for this game, and I can have the taxpayer as the column player and the auditor, taxpayer as the row player, sorry, and auditor as the column player. The taxpayer can be honest or he can cheat, the auditor can audit or not audit. If the taxpayer is honest, he gets 0, there is no payoff. While the auditor, if he audits or audits an honest taxpayer, he gets a payoff of 20. While if he does not audit an honest taxpayer, he gets a payoff of 40, because he is basically saving time and effort by not auditing an honest taxpayer. So, if he does not audit, he gets a payoff of 40. On the other hand, if the taxpayer cheats and he does not get caught, he is not audited, he gets a payoff of 40. The auditor, on the other hand, gets a payoff of 0, because he has missed a cheater, but he gets the taxpayer cheats and he gets audited, he gets a payoff of minus 100, that is, he gets a huge penalty, and the auditor gets a payoff of 40. So, this is a representative taxpayer game, where the taxpayer is honest or cheating and the auditor is auditing or not auditing. The payoffs are, the taxpayer is honest and the auditor audits, the payoffs are 0, 20. If the taxpayer is honest and the auditor does not audit, then the payoffs are 0 and 40. If the taxpayer cheats and the auditor audits, then the payoffs are minus 100 and 40. And if the taxpayer cheats and the auditor does not audit, then the payoffs are 40, 0. All right. So, this is a simple representation of a taxpayer game, right. Let us now try to see if this game has a pure strategy Nash equilibrium. Let us try to see if this game now has a pure strategy Nash equilibrium. If the auditor is auditing, then the best response of the taxpayer is to, of course, be honest, because being honest gives him 0, cheating gives him minus 100. If the taxpayer is not auditing, then the best response of the taxpayer is to cheat, because cheating gives him 40, not cheating gives him 0. Similarly, if the taxpayer is honest, best response of auditor is to not audit, because he is saying time and effort, that gives him a payoff of 40. If the taxpayer is cheating, best response of auditor is to audit, because that gives him a payoff of 40, right. And you can see there is no intersection in pure strategies. There is no intersection of best response in pure strategies. Therefore, there is no pure strategy in Nash equilibrium. Therefore, there is no pure strategy Nash equilibrium. Let us now therefore try to find a mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Let me draw this game table so that it is clear again. Again, we have two players, the taxpayer and the auditor. And the taxpayer can cheat or be honest, or the auditor can audit or not audit, and their payoffs are 0, 20, 0, 40, -100, 40, and 40, 0. And if the taxpayer is using a mixture P, 1/P, let us say. And let us say the auditor is always choosing to audit. The payoff of auditor to always choosing to audit is basically he gets a payoff of 20, because with probability P he encounters a honest. I am sorry, let me just, these options are slightly reversed. Let me just, this is the row, first row is the honest taxpayer and the second row is the cheater. If the auditor is always auditing, then he gets a payoff of 20 with probability P when he encounters an honest taxpayer, and he gets a payoff of 40 with probability 1 - P when he encounters someone who cheats on his taxes. Therefore, his average payoff of auditor who is always auditing is, well, it is 20 times P plus 40 times 1 - P equals 40 -20 P. On the other hand, if the auditor always does not audit with probability P, he gets a payoff of 40, with probability 1 - P, he gets a payoff of 0. So, the payoff of the auditor who chooses to not audit is basically with probability P, he gets 40. So, it is 40 × P plus with probability of 1 - P, he gets 0, 0 × 1 - P, which is 40 × P. And therefore, the auditor, if the payoff from auditing is always greater than the payoff from not auditing, the auditor will always audit. If the payoff from not auditing is always greater than the payoff from auditing, the auditor will not audit. All right. So, if the payoff from auditing is always greater than not auditing, the payoff, the auditor will always audit, right? And if the payoff from not auditing is always greater than the payoff from auditing, he will not audit. He will randomly choose between auditing and not auditing only when the payoffs from both of these are equal. Randomly choose, that is, the auditor will employ a mixed strategy only when 40 - 20 P is equal to 40 P, that is 40 - 20 P is equal to 40 P. Implies basically 60 P is equal to 40 implies P is equal to 40/60 is equal to 2/3, right. So, the auditor will use a mixed strategy only when P is equal to 2/3. Therefore, the mixture of the taxpayer is P equal to 2/3, mixture of taxpayer p equals 2 by 3, 1 minus p equals 1 by 3, that is pay taxes with probability p equal 2 by 3, cheat probability 1 minus p equals 1 by 3. Now, this can also be thought of as, interestingly, not one person at different instances of time choosing to pay taxes or not, but this can be thought of as across a population, different kinds of taxpayer, randomly. If you pick a person from that population with probability 2 by 3, he is paying, honestly paying his taxes. With probability 1 by 3, he is cheating on his taxes. So, you need not think of this as a game, unlike other games which we thought of as being played repeatedly in time. We can think of this game as being played across a population, right. So, across a population, we can say any given individual randomly, that is, if we pick an individual from this population randomly with probability 2 by 3, we will encounter an honest individual who is paying his taxes, and with probability 1 minus p equal to 1 by 3, we will encounter an individual who is cheating on his taxes. So, we can think of this, we can think of this mixed strategy any as across a population, that is if you randomly pick a person with probability p equal to 2 by 3, you encounter an honest taxpayer, and probability 1 minus p equal to 1 by 3, you encounter a person cheating on his taxes. You encounter a person cheating on his taxes, right. Therefore, the mixture of not one player, but the mixture across a population can be thought of as being p equal to 2 by 3, 1 minus p equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, the mixture p equal to 2 by 3, 1 minus p equal to 1 by 3. This is the mixture across the population, right. So, we have found the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium across the population of taxpayers. We can think of this as the population of taxpayers of a state, of a city, or of a country, and so on, right. Similarly, now let us try to look at the mixture of the auditor. Let us say the auditor is randomly auditing with probability q and not auditing with probability 1 minus q. If he is always auditing, his payoff is 20 times. If the taxpayer is always honest, his payoff is 0 times q plus 0 times 1 minus q, right. If the taxpayer is always honest, his payoff is 0 times q plus 0 times 1 minus q, which is equal to 0. On the other hand, if the taxpayer is always cheating, his payoff is minus 100 times q plus 40 times 1 minus q. If the taxpayer is always cheating, his payoff is minus 100 times q plus 40 times 1 minus q, which is equal to 40 minus 140 q, right. So if the taxpayer is honest, his payoff is zero. If the taxpayer is cheating, UT of C, his payoff is 40 minus 140Q, and he will randomly choose between being honest and cheating only when both these payoffs are equal, which means 0 is equal to 40 minus 140Q, which means Q is equal to 40 by 140, which is equal to 2 by 7, which means 1 minus Q is equal to 5 by 7. Therefore, the auditor is using the mixed strategy. Therefore, auditor is using the (2/7, 5/7). That is, randomly with probability 2/7, he is auditing a form. Randomly with probability 5/7, he is choosing to not audit a tax form at the Nash equilibrium. Therefore, the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium of this game is, well, for the taxpayer, the mixed strategy is 2/3, 1/3, and for the auditor, the mixed strategy is 2/7, 5/7, right. So, this is the mixed strategy of taxpayer, this is the mixed strategy of the auditor, which means to say that out of a given population, 2/3 of the individuals are honest taxpayers, 1/3 of the individuals are cheating or dishonest with their taxes, and the auditor is randomly choosing to audit 2/5 or 2/7 of the tax forms, and he is choosing to not audit 5/7 of the tax forms. This is the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium of the tax paying game. This is the mixed strategy any of the tax. This is the mixed strategy Nash equilibrium of the taxpayer scale. All right. I hope you've been able to appreciate this interesting application of mixed strategy Nash equilibrium to the population of taxpayers. So we will stop this module here and continue in the next module. Thank you. Thank you very much.